Hey guys, my name is Cam, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. As you can tell by the title of this video, I will be giving my 2023 K-pop photo card collection update. I know it's been like an entire year basically since I last posted. I've been MIA for the past like 10 months, but I still am very active on my Instagram, which is now at Juhyuncore and Juhyunsales on Instagram. And I'm very, very much selling, trading, and collecting photo cards. So if you want to, feel free to follow me there since I know that I haven't been active on YouTube at all. But yeah, I really wanted to give y'all an update on my collections and also give you kind of like an update that I'm still alive, since I do like from time to time get comments saying like I miss your videos and stuff, which makes me really, really happy but kind of sad at the same time since I don't post anymore. So I really wanted to put this video out for those of you who might have missed my videos or content over the last year or so. Hope all of you had a super duper safe and great holiday season, and we'll have a great 2023 to come. But yeah, I'm going to quit my rambling and quickly get into my collection. So now I'm down to just one binder instead of having like two or three like I did in my previous video. And I did make this collage out of the SMCU 2021 album, the Red Velvet version. So I made this little like Irene collage, which I'm really, really happy with. And there's nothing on the side. The binder is breaking a little. I'm not sure if you can see like the crack here, but it does keep all of my photo cards safe and sound in here. So I've been continuing to use it. And yeah, let's get right into it. On the inside pocket here, I just have the collage that I used to use for my OT5 Red Velvet collection, as well as just like some random packaging from like some aespa goods and Stacy goods. And yeah, without further ado, I'll get into my collections. So first off is my Irene collection, and you'll see a big change and growth in this collection since my last collection video. I did decide to selectively collect non-album photo cards for Irene, as well as all of her album photo cards, but with a twist kind of, which you'll see. So as you can tell, I did decide to collect 3 copies of every single Irene album photo card, and this was completely inspired and taken from Boomerang BJY on Instagram, since I believe that their collection, they have 3 of every single Joy photo card ever, not just the album photo cards, but also like the really, really rare non-album photo cards. And of course I can't do that, so I decided to just opt for 3 of every single of Irene's album photo cards instead. But yeah, I'll really quickly do a flip through. So we start out with Ice Cream Cake, The Red, The Velvet, Russian Roulette, both of the rookie versions. Here I'm missing one of the Red Summer ones, but I do have it on the way. And then her other Red Summer one, then one of her Peekaboo photo cards, her other Peekaboo photo card, and then her 2 The Perfect Red Velvet photo cards. Next is Summer Magic, so I have her normal and then her 2 limited cards with the clear ones at the bottom, her 2 RBB photo cards, and then her Day 1 guidebook photo card, her 2 Day 1 version photo cards, and then her Day 2 guidebook. And then I am missing one of her Day 2 version photo cards, which is the Shouting one. For some reason, I feel like this is literally the hardest Irene album photo card to find. I don't know what it is about it, but yeah, I feel like I've struggled to find this card so much over this last year. But I do have 3 of her Shadow Reigns, and then this is one of the finale version photo cards. Here are her 3 finale scrapbook version photo cards with the iconic sewing machine rain in the middle. This is her last finale version photo card, and then I decided to not collect 3 of her monster photo cards each, so I just have the 6 that I had in my original Irene collection. Next we get into Queendom era, so we have the girls version and then the 2 queens versions with the iconic latte rain in the middle. And now we get into the 2022 releases, so we have Feel My Rhythm, which was by far my favorite Red Velvet release or any release of the entire year last year. I feel like Feel My Rhythm was just an incredible era, like musically and concept wise, so I absolutely fell in love with this era. So we have her Orgel version photo card and then her 2 Reva version photo cards. And then I am still working on Birthday, but for now I just have her SM Mini photo card and then her Cake version photo card. I am still working to get her photo book version photo card, as well as her Digipack version photo card, but I should have them secured eventually. Next we have the 2021 SMCU photo cards, as well as one of the 2022 ones that I pulled in one of my copies. So these 3 up here are from the SM Town version, which was like the one where SM was really stupid and gave us 2 out of 55 versions. And then this one and this one are from the Red Velvet version. This card in the middle is from this year's SMCU album, and I think it's the membership version, I want to say. And luckily I pulled it in one of my copies. I am still working to find like the Palace and Portrait ID version photo cards, which are just just like the SM Town version from last year, and they're like 2 out of 55. I don't know why the hell SM gave us two versions of the album with 55 cards again. But yeah, the SMCU Palace photo cards will definitely be a journey for me this year. And then we have her three Kinos. So we have Bad Boy, Day 1, and Day 2. And without the Kino reprints that they had earlier this year, I definitely would have never dreamed of having three Bad Boy Kinos. And I think the Bad Boy Kinos were actually like the start or catalyst of like my three Rain collection, as I like to call it. Because as they were being reprinted, I thought it would be like the only opportunity I would ever have in hopes of like completing this set, I guess. But yeah, these are Irene's Kinos. Definitely like my favorite page probably of her album photo cards. And then we just have some random ID photo cards, as well as her three Japanese photo cards, which I did not decide to collect three of for obvious reasons because they're so expensive. So we have Cookie Jar, Sappy, and then Bloom, which just came out this year as well. And then two of her SMCU ID photo cards, as well as this one from this year's copy. Next, we'll get into my non-album Irene photo card collection. So I basically decided to collect any selfies and then hologram Sandee photo cards that Irene has, but I did make like a few exceptions for like some concept version photo cards that I really liked. So these first few pages will be like her non-selfie and her concept version photo cards, and then we'll get into her selfie and then her hologram photo cards towards the end. But yeah, starting off, we just have some Trolls photo cards, as well as their 7th or their 8th anniversary trading card set. So this is the trading card. This is from Trolls and like so on and so forth for this page. But I am still looking for her Pantone Passport wallet photo card, which has like a picture of her from Summer Magic era, which I really, really want. So if any of you have it or see it for sale or trade, feel free to let me know. Next, we have her Red Room collect book, her Peekaboo collect book, and then her Peekaboo paper holder. This is her Redmer hologram wallet, I want to say. And then this is a 2019 11th Street lenticular pob, as well as the Le Rouge holo photo card that came with the keyring, I want to say. But I don't know what's up with this card, but I feel like it doesn't like have that much holo compared to like the Sulgi that I used to have in my collection. But going to the bottom here, I have two of her Double Patty promotional photo cards. I think this was similar to like the Megabox Trolls event that they had, where they just handed them out at theaters in Korea. And in the corner here, I have her Day 1 and Day 2 ticket from the Day 1 and Day 2 albums. Up here, I have her Day 1 sticker, which was just like random from my friend. And then her finale lenticular that came with the hologram set, as well as her finale projector keyring. Next is the concept version sticker from the Queendom Epoxy sticker set, as well as the 2022 concept photo card. And then this is a replica of the Vietnam bracelet, I think. So it is a replica that I ordered from Epiphanies, I think is their username. But yeah, this is like one of the few replicas I have in my collection. But I really, really wanted this photo card since, as you could tell by like the cover of like this section and my binder, I really, really like the concept from the 2021 SMCU. And then on the bottom here, I made some exceptions for Feel My Rhythm, and I got her acrylic standee and then her glass cup photo cards because I feel like these photo cards were way too good to pass up on. And in the corner here, I have some ID photos from the Troll set, as well as the 2019 pre-order from Anstore, I want to say. This is just a page for like random goods slash cashbees and gift cards. So I have her Happiness SM Town Museum bookmark, her Peekaboo cashbee, her Summer Magic cashbee, her RBB cashbee, her Switzerland cashbee, and then her G-Market photo card. These two are definitely like a struggle to get, and I didn't think I would get them originally, but I stumbled upon the G-Market one for a really good price, and I was able to trade for this cashbee. So yeah, super duper happy with those two photo cards. Now we get into my favorite section of my Irene on album collection. That's the selfie version photo cards. So up here, I've saved spaces for the third anniversary photo card, which I doubt that I'll ever get, but I guess I just wanted to save a space just in case I do come upon them. But here I have her two 2018 birthday photo cards, which were randomly listed on eBay a couple months back for like a really, really good price. So I'm super duper happy to have those in my collection since I know that those are pretty rare as well. Next, I have her two La Rouge selfie photo cards. This one is from the ticket holder and this is from the fortune set. These two, I think, are my favorite Irene photo cards hands down in my entire collection. I feel like just the two of them together right next to each other are just so good, and like the filters that she used are really, really, really cute as well. So super duper happy to have these. Down here I have the La Rouge photo book photo card, her fan kit 1.0 card, and then her fan kit 2.0 photo card. Here's her A Precious Moments collect book photo card, her Monster with Fan slash EZU pre-order benefit, her Trolls beret or like denim concept photo card that came in like the set. This is her 2021 Season's Greetings photo pack, her two Queendom like interview photo cards. So this one was from the AR set, and then this one was from the Epoxy set, her Queendom Mumo, and her two SMCU 2021 photo cards. So I think this one came with the metal badge, and then this one came with the AR ticket set. This is her 2022 Season's Greetings photo pack, and then this came with her acrylic mirror, which they randomly released this year. It was super duper random, and I remember them like selling out in like the first like few hours or something, and everyone was scrambling to get them, but then they restocked and now they're like pretty easy to find, I think. Next is probably my favorite pop, and that is her Mumo one from Feel My Rhythm era. I remember when this card dropped, it was like impossible for me to find anywhere, but thankfully I was able to secure it in a trade, so I'm really glad to have this in my collection as well. Next, I saved a spot for her SM Town & Store winner photo card for Feel My Rhythm, but that's another card like the third anniversary ones that I doubt that I'll be able to find, but I just decided to leave a space just in case I do. And then we finished the page off with some more Feel My Rhythm pre-order slash fan call benefits. So this is her with fan slash EZU, and then these two are from KMS Station, I wanna say. I might correct myself if I'm wrong, but yep, there are those. And here are like some of the newest selfie photo cards that she's had. So this is from the SM Town Live badge set, I think. And then this one is from the epoxy sticker or tattoo set. I saved a space for her AR slot machine photo card. I'll put a picture of it up, but I think it's kind of hard to find and like over $100. So I might not be able to get that one in a while either. And then in this row, I just have her 3/8th anniversary cards. So this one is from the necklace. This is from the acrylic set. And then this one is from like the Fortune Lucky card set. And then I've saved this page for all of her birthday pops. Right now, I only have her SM Global Shop one, as you can see, and I'm really happy to have that one, but I am still waiting to get the Makestar and K-Town For You one, I think, and the rest of them should be on the way. But yeah, I wasn't really happy that SM released so many pops this era, since this was like the first time that they've done anything more than like the Chinese sites and then Mumo. Yeah, they kind of went crazy with like all of the Korean sites, so, but I am excited, I guess, to have some more photo cards in my Irene collection. And then finally, for my non-album Irene collection, I have all of her holo photo cards. We have the Red Mirror holo sticker set, Bad Boy, Summer Magic, RBB, Day 1, Day 2, Finale, Monster, and then Queendom. And then on this next page, I just have her Feel My Rhythm one for now, but I think there is one for the SMCU 2022 merch line that just got announced. So I will have another one up here, and the rest will fill up probably eventually in a few years. And now I just have some miscellaneous goods, so I'll just quickly flip through here since I'm sure that most of you just care about the photo cards. Here I have her red large photo card slash postcard that they released like a long time ago, as well as her Smilebox postcard, which I know like these two are pretty rare. And yeah, that's it for my Irene collection. I'm super duper happy with all the progress in the last year, and I can't wait for it to grow more, especially with all the birthday pops, like I said before. And yeah, now we'll get into my Chaeyoung collection, which I just started maybe like 3 or 4 months ago. So it is like very much a work in progress, and there's a lot of gaps in this collection. But it is exciting, I guess, to collect a newer group since Le Sserafim just debuted last year, as opposed to like Espo or Stacey debuting in 2020. So yeah, I have decided to collect only album photo cards and then select like pops and like other photo cards, I guess, for Chaeyoung, but I'm trying to be very, very strict and just stick to album photo cards basically. And in the left page here, I just have her postcard from the compact version for Anti-Fragile, as well as the one day postcard, which I've had for like a few years now probably. But yeah, I'll really, really quickly go through these since, like I said, there are like a lot of gaps in the collection. So we just have her colorized photo cards, two of her hard eyes photo cards from the Sapphire version. This is one of her photo cards from the I Was version for Blue Eyes. Another card for I Was, and then another one for I Am version. I don't have any I Will version photo cards for Blue Eyes, unfortunately, but going into One Iric Diary, I do have these two from the 3D version, I want to say. That's wrong, I'll crack myself down here somewhere. But yeah, I feel like Chaeyoung has been really hard to collect, but I am really, really happy with this Fishbowl Chaeyoung that I was able to find, as well as these two cards down here, which are from One Reeler. I don't remember the version names for One Reeler off the top of my head, but I just have this outdoor concept and then this finger heart one, and that's it for the Eyes One cards. I don't know why the Eyes One cards are so hard to collect. come by nowadays. I think all the albums are out of print, so it makes it really, really hard for like new collectors to jump into collecting them. But now we get into her photo cards as Le Sserafim. So I have her Black Petrol and Blue Cypher version photo cards from the Fearless era, as well as her K-Town for You pop right here. And then I saved a space for her version 1 photo card, but right now I just have Candy Chaewon and then the Iridescent Opal version photo card. I do have the Midnight Onyx one on the way, I'm pretty sure though. And then for this page, I started to save room for her Compact version photo cards, as well as her Weverse version photo cards. So I just have these three, and then this one is the Weverse version one. Here I just have a page for like some miscellaneous slash random Chaewon photo cards. So I have her 2 Catalina photo cards, which I'm so happy to have, from the One Eyric Theater, I want to say, yeah. As well as the other one that came like with the Blu-ray set, I want to say. And then here I just have 2 extra Fearless pops. So this one is from Weverse, and this is also from Weverse, I think, actually. And then an extra unit from the compact version with Kazuha and then Chaewon, of course. But yeah, that's it for Chaewon. Like I said, super duper exciting to collect, and I'm really happy with how it's come along so far. Next, we'll be getting into my Karina collection. I have like kind of slowed down with this collection. I'm not sure what I want to do with it in the future, since I have been diverting so many funds towards Chaewon and Irene. I haven't really like felt the need to spend as much on my Karina or Isa collection. So in the future, I might just be collecting her album photo cards or like select photo cards. Probably be downsizing my Karina collection quite a bit, just because I don't feel like the need to collect all of her photo cards anymore, I guess. But yeah, let's get into it. In here I just have her large photo card from their season's greetings last year, as well as one of the TAMS promotional sticker sets. Starting off with Black Mamba era, we have her Holo Lenti set, her SM Global Shop pop that she got for ordering merch, as well as her Epoxy set. And then these two, I believe, are from the Ant Store trading card set. Next we have Forever era, so this is her Cashby, her Holo, and then her Shaker keyring photo card. Here are her 2 Ant Store trading pack photo cards for that respective era. And then for next level, we have her Holo, her Magnet, her Acrylic Charm slash Keyring, her SM Global Shop Pub, and then this is a replica of the Fan Call Event photo card. Down here are her 2 Ant Store trading cards as well. These two are really, really pretty. Up here, I saved a space for the Eternal Return photo card, which I never ended up getting. I think last year in my collection video, I thought that I had it on the way, but then the person that I was trading with agreed to send out first, but then it never arrived to me. So that trade never worked out, I guess. But yeah, next we just have some promotional photo cards. So we have Cleo and then Metaheal round 1 and round 2, as well as her Eider photo card, I think is what it's called. And then on the bottom corner, these are her 4 Savage trading cards from Ant Store. Next is a full page of her album photo cards for Savage, as well as the SM Global Shop pops right down the middle. I did decide to like mark some of my favorite cards of hers like in here, just so that I wouldn't forget to mention them. So we just have Bo-Rina and then Bunny-Rina, of course, 2 of her most iconic photo cards. Next we have her Holo for Savage, and then her 2 deluxe box photo cards. I feel like this long sleeve one is so pretty. I love it so much, as well as her short sleeve version up there in the corner. This was her non-selfie SM Global Shop pop that came with like all of the versions, and then her 2 Mumo pre-order benefits, so round 1 and round 2, and then her 2 Savage 100k like merchandise photo cards that you got for buying like 100,000 won worth of Savage merchandise, I think. And then in the corner here we have her Savage SM Global Shop pop. Up here are her 3 Yeezy Hue photo cards. So we have round 1, round 2, and round 3. Remember, I was really, really struggling with this round 1 photo card, and I ended up accidentally buying like 2 of the round 3 or 2 of the round 2 or something, since I mistook it for the round 1 photo card because they all look so similar. But yeah, that's it for Savage era. So we get into Dreams Come True and then Got the Beat down here. So this is her Dreams Come True Holo, her Dreams Come True sticker set, and then her Dreams Come True SM Global Shop Pob, her Got the Beat Holo, and then her Got the Beat sticker. Her Party On XR Live collectbook photo cards. So this is the first version and the second version. Her Cleo round 2, I think, photo card. And then these are all Season's Greetings photo cards. So this one is a pub. This one is from the Season's Greetings itself. Another pub with the different concept. And then these two are from the Season's Greetings photo pack. Next, we have a bunch of SMCU photo cards. So these two came in the Espa version. This is the SM Town version one. And then these are all like random merch ones. This is another replica, just like the Irene one from Epiphanies, of the Vietnam bracelet photo card. But in the middle here, we have her AR ticket set, her badge set, and then this is the passport set ID, I think. And then down here, we have Cleo round 3 slash round 4, I want to say. And then this wraps up the end of like my non-album photo card stuff for Karina. So we have her antique mirror set, her Tam's promotional acrylic card, her random dakji that you get if you visit an store in Korea, and then her ID from the passport set. And finally, in the center here, we have her Life's Too Short concert photo card that you got during the LA showcase, which I actually did go to. I'll try to remember to put some pictures up here, but I went last year in like July or June, was it? It's really, really amazing. I had a great time, and yeah, got that photo card from there. And then finally, we have her girls album photo cards. So luckily, I was able to finish this set, but we just have the two digipack photo cards. This is the Target exclusive, I think. This is the actual digipack photo card. Then these two rows are from the Real World and Kwangya, or like large photo book versions. And the one in the corner here is the other US exclusive for the photo books. And just like for my Irene collection, I know y'all care about the photo cards. So I'll really quickly flip through all of these non-album larger goods. But yeah, that is my Kadena collection. Really excited to see where it goes, I guess, in the future, since I know that I don't want to collect non-album for her. So whether that means album photo cards or like selective non-album, we'll see. But yeah, the final collection I have in this binder is my Stacey Isa collection. I did make a few changes to like my collecting policies, I guess, for Isa. So I am only collecting her album photo cards and then pops that fill up like the 9 pocket page. So if there's 4 album photo cards for that era, I'll collect like 5 non-album photo cards or like pops for that era, if that makes sense. I don't know what I'm going to do from like So Bad to Stereotype era, since like previously I did collect like every single pop, so I might end up selling them off. I'm not sure yet, but yeah, let's get right into it. I don't think any of like these first few eras have changed, so I'll really quickly go through these. These are her two album photo cards. This is Apple Music, Market Shop, G Market, Oh What, MMT, Beat Road, and then Make Star. Still can't believe that I memorized all of those. Her Two Tower Records Polaroids. This is the 40,000 or 80,000 won event that they did for their ASAP merch. Her two ASAP album photo cards. Apple Music Round 1 with Drama. I think this one might be Music Korea, but don't quote me on that. This is Makestar Round 1. MMT, Apple Music Round 2. Market Shop / Oh What. Makestar Round 2 with Drama Round 2. And then this one I want to say is from G Market, like the G Market unit photo card. And then these three are from the ASAP merchandise line. So one of them is from the binder, one of them is from the tin set, and then this is from the perfume set. Now we get into Stereotype era, still my favorite Stacey era ever. It hasn't changed from last year. So we have her 5 album photo cards. So this is from version 1, version 2, and then this is the special version photo card that came in like all of the albums with the iconic Princess Aiza in the middle. This came from her Stereotype MD. I think it came with like a deco top loader or something and stickers. This is Weverse, I think. Market Shop, MMT. Withdrama round 2 / like the lucky draw set. I still never was able to find Withdrama round 3. Like now that I'm thinking about it, I might not really go back and collect it, since I'm pretty happy with like the collection overall right now. This is Withdrama round 4. It took me forever to get this card, since like the GOM ghosted us for like 2 or 3 months, but thankfully the GOM eventually returned and was able to send out the cards to us. This is Apple Music round 1, round 2, round 3, and then round 4. Makestar round 1, round 2, round 3, round 4, and I think this is Makestar round 5. They went up to 5 rounds this time for Makestar. And then we have Oh What or Why Global, I want to say. And then this last one is from Lazada, and then these two are from her season's greetings from last year. And then for these last two pages, you'll see like how I've been collecting for 2022 Isa. So for Run To You, I just collected her album photo cards. So these two. So these two are from the normal version album, and this one is from the jewel case, as well as her AR photo card. This one's from Apple Music, Withdrama, Apple Music round 2, or like a different Apple Music event, I want to say. Withdrama, like the special jewel case event. And then this one is from Weverse. These two down here are so cute. And then finally, we have We Need Love era, which just came out a few months ago. It's actually 6 months ago now that I think about it. But I am still missing 2 of her album photo cards, as well as her circle photo cards. So that's why like I've left 3 spaces. So I have these 2 photo cards. I'm not sure if it's the love version or the power version. I'll put it down here of like which version it is. But this is the Polaroid that came if you bought a set of albums for their Withdrama Lucky Draw set. This is one of the photo cards from that set, as well as her 2 broadcast photo cards. This is week 1 and week 2. 2. I don't have week 3 and I don't really think I plan on getting it, but I'm really, really happy to have these two photo cards. I remember I was on like the Stacy tags around the time that they were promoting Beautiful Monster. I was like, these are pretty good prices. I might as well just buy them because they're really, really cute cards and they'll help fill up the page, I guess. But yeah, I'm not sure what I'm going to do with my Isaac collection in the future, but I am really, really happy where it's ended up as of now. But yeah, we've reached the end of my entire photo card collection. I know this page is incomplete because of the third anniversary cards, but I really wanted to end on it since it has my favorite photo cards, this entire binder right here. But yeah, thank you all so much for staying to the end of this video. I really, really hope y'all enjoyed seeing like my collection as of the beginning of 2023. Thank you all so much for supporting and staying with me this last year, and to any like new viewers that happen to stumble across this video. I really, really hope that your 2023 is amazing and super duper safe and healthy. I don't know when I'll be posting another video, but if y'all want to keep up to date with me or like my collections or anything, feel free to check out my Instagrams at @juhyuncore/@juhyunsales. But yeah, that basically brings me to the end of this video. Again, I really hope you guys enjoyed. And as usual, don't forget to stay safe, healthy, and loud. And I'll see y'all in my next video. Peace!